Hi children, how are you all? I think you all enjoyed the videos on arithmetic progression from part 1 to part 3. Now, today we are watching part 4 of arithmetic progression. In this video, we are going to solve some problems related to arithmetic progression, which are also important for the examination. Here is the first problem. Find the sum 25 plus 28 plus 31 etc. plus 100. We know that this is an arithmetic progression. And if we want to find the sum of all the terms of the arithmetic progression, then it is known as arithmetic series. To find the sum of this arithmetic series, what are all the things given if we identify? The first term is given, it is 25. And the common difference D is 3. How to calculate the common difference that you already know? That is second term minus first term. 28 minus 25 is 3. Like that, 31 minus 28 is also 3. And the last term AN is given. That is 100. The formula we are going to use here is SN equals N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. I think you all recalled that formula. To substitute the value of n in the formula, we need to find the value of n. How to find the value of n? By using the formula an equals a plus n minus 1 into d. That is the last term. The value of last term is 100 and the value of a is 25 and that of d is 3. We don't know the value of n. So substituting all the values in this formula, we have 100 equals 25 plus n minus 1 into 3. So taking 25 to 100 side, 100 minus 25 is 75. This side we are left with 3 times n minus 1. 3 times n minus 1 is 75. So n minus 1 equals 75 divided by 3, cross multiplying 3 to this side. And simplification, we have 25. Yes, n minus 1 equals 25. Therefore, the value of n equals 25 minus when transferred to this side is plus 1, or adding plus 1 on both the side, we have 26. Therefore, the number of terms in the given arithmetic series is 26. Now, we know a, d and n. We can easily calculate the sum up to n terms. That means sum up to 26 terms. So substituting the value of n, it is 26 by 2. 2 is there in the formula. The value of a is 25 plus n minus 1 means 26 minus 1, that is 25. You can directly substitute it also into common difference is 3. So simplifying this 25 into 2, it is 50. And 26 minus 1 is 25. 25 3 is 75. 50 plus 75 is 125. And half of 26, that is 26 by 2 is 13. If we multiply 125 and 13, we got 1625. Therefore, the sum of 26 terms of an AP is 1625. So the next problem is very interesting. 200 lakhs are stocked in the following manner. Here 200 lakhs are stocked in this manner. 20 lakhs in the bottom. In the bottom, there are 20 lakhs. And 19 lakhs above that row. That is next to this bottom row, there are 19 lakhs. Above that, 18 lakhs. Here it is 18 lakhs. And so on. In how many rows, the total 200 lakhs placed and how many lakhs are in the top row? If we go on placing like this, so how many rows are there to place the 200? How many rows will be formed to place 200 lakhs? And at the top of the row, how many lakhs will be there? That means the given problem is in arithmetic sequence. Number of lakhs in first row is 20. In the second row, it is 19, and the next row is 18, and so on. The sequence is 20, 19, 18, 17, and it is decreasing. How much it is decreasing? It is decreasing by 1. Hence, the common difference is minus 1, and the first term is 20, and the total logs we have is 200. If you sum up all these logs, you are going to get 200 logs. Yes, that means the value of SN equals 200. Now, substituting in the formula SN equals n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, we get 200 equals n by 2 into 2 times 20 plus n minus 1 into minus 1, because common difference is minus 1 because the terms are decreasing. Cross multiplying this 2 to 2 this side, it is 400. We are left with n into 20 2s are 40, then minus into plus, plus 1 and plus into minus, minus n. Here this n and this one n. So next, after multiplying, n into 40 is 40n, n into plus 1 is n, n into minus n is minus n square, and transferring all this to this side, we have n square minus 41n plus 400 equals 0. This is a quadratic equation. We know how to factorize this. Yes. So we have to think of two terms whose sum is minus 41 and the product is plus 400. Which are those two terms? Think. Yes. N square minus 25n minus 16n plus 400. If you add minus 25 and minus 16, you are going to get minus 41. If you multiply these two, minus into minus plus 25 into 16 is 400. Taking the common terms out, we have n minus 25 into n minus 16 equals 0. These two are the factors of this equation. Equating it to 0, we have n equals 16 and n equals 25. There are two answers for this question. We have to check which one is correct. Let us substitute that there are 16 rows. Therefore, the last term will be T16 equals A plus 15D. We know the value of A and we know the value of D. It is minus 1. 20 minus 15 equals 5. In the last row, we will get 5 logs and there are 16 rows. Yes. Let us check with the n equals 25. In the last row, how many logs we are going to get if we put the value of n equals 25? T25 equals a plus 24 times d, which is equal to 20 minus 24, which is equal to minus 4. Yes. So here we are getting minus 4 logs in the last row. This is not possible. Hence, n equals 16 is the correct answer. That means there are 16 rows, or we can say 200 logs are placed in 16 rows, and in the last row we have 5 logs. Yes. So let us move on to the next problem. The problem is like this. Find the sum of first 51 terms of an AP whose second and third terms are 14 and 18 respectively. To find the sum of first 51 terms of the AP, here the second and the third term is given. To find the sum of 51 terms, we need A, we need D, and also we need the value of N to substitute in the equation SN equals N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. Since these two terms are consecutive, second and third, we can subtract 14 from 18. If you subtract 14 from 18, we get the value of D as 4. But if the two terms are not consecutive, if they give like this, if the sixth term of an AP is this much and if the ninth term of an AP is this much, then how to solve? I'm going to explain. Write like this. The second term is given, it is 14 and the value n equals 2. Therefore, the second term we know A plus D, the value is 14, like that. The third term is A plus 2D, which is equal to 18. We get two equation. Solving these two pairs of linear equation, we are going to get AA cancels, 2D minus D equals D, 18 minus 14 equals 4. The value of D equals 4. Substituting the value of D in any one of the equation, we are going to get the value of A. The value of A is 10. Now we know the value of A, we know the value of D, and we know the number of terms, that is 51. N equals 51. Now we are going to calculate the sum of first 51 terms of this arithmetic series. So by substituting in the equation, Sn equals n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, and on simplification we get Sn or S 51 equals 51 by 2 into 20 plus 200, which is equal to 51 by 2 into 220, that is half of 220, that is if you divide 220 by 2 you get 110. 110 into 51 equals 5610. So this how we solve this problem. Let us move on to the one more problem, important and interesting. A spiral is made up of successive semicircles with centers alternately at A and B. Starting with centers at A of radius 0.5 cm, 1.0 cm, 1.5 cm, 2.0 cm. What is the total length of such a spiral made up of 13th consecutive semicircle? Take pi equals 22 by 7. Let us visualize this problem. Yes, a spiral is made up of successive semicircle. This is the one semicircle. This is one more semicircle. So for this semicircle, we have A as center. For the second semicircle, we have B as the center. For the third semicircle, we have A as the center. For the fourth semicircle, we have B as center. Like this, alternatively, A and B will be the centers of the semicircles. First semicircle, second semicircle, third semicircle, fourth semicircle. Like this, what is the total length of such spiral made up of 13 consecutive semicircle? What will be the total length of this semicircles, 13 consecutive semicircle? That means we have to find the length of each semicircle. What is the length of each semicircle? It is nothing but half of the circumference. First, let us recall what is circumference of circle. Circumference of circle is given by 2 pi r. Circumference of semicircle is half of circumference, that is half of 2 pi r, which is equal to pi r. Now, what is the circumference of the first semicircle? To find the circumference of the semicircle, we need r, radius of that semicircle. The radius of the first semicircle is 0.5. If you multiply that by pi, you are going to get 0.5 pi. Like that, second semicircle, the radius is 1 and you are going to get pi into 1. For the third semicircle, the radius is 1.5 and you are going to get 1.5 pi. Like this, the circumference of the 13th semicircle is pi into 6.5. How it is this 6.5? If you observe the radius, in each case, it is increasing 0.5. Instead of adding 0.5 13 times, if you multiply 13 into 5, we get 65. Since it is 0.5, 13 into 0.5 is 6.5. Therefore, 6.5 into pi is the circumference of the 13th semicircle. Then the sequence will be 0.5, 1 pi, 1.5, etc., 6.5. Taking pi as common, we have the sequence 0.5, 1, 1.5, etc. up to 6.5. Let us consider the sum of this series as S. Taking pi as common, it is written as pi into S. Now we know n equals 13, a equals 0.5, and the last term l equals 6.5. Let us find the sum of this series 0.5, 1, 1.5 etc. up to 6.5 by using the formula Sn equals n by 2 into a plus l. So here n is 13 by 2 and the first term is 0.5 and the last term is 6.5. We get 13 into 7 by 2, that is 91 by 2. Half of 91 is 45.5. We have the sum of this series is 45.5, but we have to multiply that by pi to get the total length of the spiral. Pi into S equals 22 by 7 into 45.5. The length of the spiral is 143 centimeter. This how we solve the problems which involves arithmetic sequence and series children. One more problem is like this. If m times the mth term of an AP is equal to n times the nth term and m is not equal to n, show that its m plus nth term is 0. Let the first term of AP equals A, common difference is D. In both the case, since the AP is same, A is the first term and D is the last term. We have to show that m plus nth term is 0. A plus of m plus n minus 1 into D equals 0. So let us write the mth term. Mth term is a plus m minus 1 into d. Nth term is a plus n minus 1 into d. M times mth term is m into a plus m minus 1 into d. N times nth term is we have to multiply this term by n times. Now simplifying, that is multiplying by m into a m into m square d. M into minus 1 is minus md. Like that, here this side we have an plus n square d minus nd. So transferring to one side and taking the common factors out, we have a into m minus n plus m square minus n square into d minus m minus n into d equals 0. Splitting m square minus n square by using the formula a square minus b square as m minus n into m plus n and dividing the equation by m minus n, we are going to get, or taking m minus n as common, both we can do. A equals m plus n minus 1 into d equals 0 divided by m minus n equals 0. We are left with a plus m plus n minus 1 into d. We know this term is nothing but the m plus nth term, that is a plus m plus n minus 1 into d, which is equal to 0. We have proved that m plus nth term is 0. The next problem is like this. If the sum of the first p terms of an AP is the same as the sum of first q terms, both the problems appears to be same. The previous one dealt with the terms. Now this is dealing with the sum. So read the problem carefully, children. Then show that the sum of first p plus q terms is 0. Here sum is given by the formula Sn equals n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, and they have given the condition sum of p terms is equal to sum of q terms. Here they are telling that the sum of first p terms and ap is the same as the sum of first q terms. So what will be the sum of p plus q terms? Substitute p plus q in place of n, we get this expression. Now sum of p terms means p by 2 into 2a plus p minus 1 into d. Similarly, sum of q terms means we get this expression. So both are equal. The condition is given in the problem itself. Now simplifying, multiplying and transferring to one side, we get this expression. So in this expression, after simplification and taking common factors out, we are left with 2a into p minus q plus p plus q into p minus q minus p minus q into d equals 0. Throughout dividing by p minus q, we are left with 2a plus p plus q minus 1 into d equals 0, which is p plus qth term. Yes. So now multiplying both the side by p plus q by 2, because it is an equation, if we multiply anything on both the side, the value does not change. Therefore, we have p plus q by 2 into 2a plus p plus q minus 1 into d. The same equation we get here. Therefore, s p plus q equals 0. That is, the sum of p plus q the term is 0. Hence, we proved. So, here I have discussed 5 to 6 problem, children. But you have to solve so many problems to understand better and to acquire the perfectness. So for that reason, I am sharing you a question bank prepared by us. So the question bank will be available in this web address. If you type this web address in your search bar, you will get the question bank. Download the question bank. We have tried to answer few question by observing the worked example, solve the remaining question, and I think you all understood arithmetic progression, arithmetic sequences very well. So do well, all the best. For any doubts, post it in the comment box. I will try to answer in the comment box. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.